Hi everybody and welcome to another Daily Dose of Jace Tutorials. So in this video I'm going to discuss the three reasons why you should get a MacBook Air 2017 in the year 2019. So let's get to it. So first up, USB ports. The 2017 MacBook Air has two USB ports, one on each side. They're USB 3.0 so I can charge my phone, which is awesome. You also got your sdxc card reader and your Thunderbolt port. In the new 2019 version, you'd have to use a dongle just to charge your phone. So for me, the 2017 is still a big win. So reason number two, the hard drive space. The 2017 version has a 128GB SSD. Same thing as the 2019, that's why I wanted to stick with the 2017 instead, since I'm getting the same amount of hard drive space. If the minimum for the 2019 was 256, I might probably go with that, but for me, this is another win for the 2017. And reason number three, the price. Right off the bat, I save an easy $249. I know the screen resolution for the 2017 is not the best, but for me, it'll get the job done. I'm actually editing iMovie for this video on the MacBook Air. So, you know, especially when you're in school, you're on a budget, $250 is a big deal plus tax. So really depends on what you're going to use it for. I'm not going to be doing any heavy editing or anything like that. So definitely the MacBook Air 2017, another big win. And then just a special mention, glowing Apple logo. That thing is awesome. That's why I want to go with the 2017. And the keyboard, backlit keyboard. I know all of them have backlit keyboards, but for me, all my other computers don't even have backlit keyboards. So for me, as long as it's got a backlit keyboard, it's good enough for me. Not to mention software updates. This thing will be good for another 4 to 5 years if you're worried about software updates, because Apple supports their devices for up to 7 years. So I'm not too worried about it. You know, within 5 years, I'd probably be using the heck out of this thing. So I really appreciate everybody watching. Take it easy.